Here are two materials that as you rotate them, it doesn't really change how they reflect the light. Here's a material where it does. As you rotate it, the light reflects in different ways. The second kind of material is called anisotropic, compared to isotropic, which is how most materials are. Good examples of anisotropic materials are brushed aluminum and velvet. A simple way of making a material anisotropic is to give the object a pair of normals instead of a single normal. In this exercise, you start off with our energy-balanced Blinfong reflection model for a plane. What I want you to do is change the single normal to be two normals, as if the material has grooves in it. If you look closely at the fragment shader, you'll see I cheat a bit. I take the fragment's location and use its X and Z position to make these new normals. I can do this because I know the original normal is mostly pointing up the Y-axis. Your job is to take these two normals and use them instead of the original normal. Basically, you need to apply the reflection model twice, once to each normal. To keep things about the same intensity, make both of these contributions be each just half as strong. I'd like to point out that GLSL has the idea of a loop built into it. This should prove handy for this exercise. Here's the result, which, even though it's a hack, looks pretty nice, I don't mind saying. Remember, the major rule of graphics is, it just has to look right. One thing to keep in mind, the groove parameter, when set to zero, should give a result exactly the same as the original reflection model. If it doesn't, you'll need to figure out what to fix.